Hey guys, Merkeebs here, and in this video, I'll be checking out the Yunzi AL-75, a follow-up to Yunzi's popular AL-66. So the board was sent over by the guys at Yunzi for me to check out and give my honest thoughts on, so all relevant links on where to get your hands on this board will be in the video description down below. But as usual, all thoughts and opinions are always my own. So the Yunzi AL-75 is a brand new board available from Yunzi's website priced at just $110, with the board available in two different colorways with two different switch choices. You have your choice between black or silver for the casing. Then for your switches, you can pick between the Yunzi blue-gray tactile switches or Yunzi's cocoa cream V2 linear switches. But in case you don't want to go the pre-built route and feel like putting the board together yourself with your own switches and keycaps, a bare-bones kit is also available for just $95. The unit that Yunzi sent me is pre-built in the silver colorway with Yunzi's Cocoa Cream V2 linear switches. And now for the unboxing. Opening up the box, you're first greeted by the user manual, which details all the shortcuts and basic info about the board. Then underneath that is the board itself wrapped in plastic with a plastic dust cover, safely packed between some foam. We'll take a look at the rest of the board in a bit, right after checking out the included accessories. Inside a provided accessory box we get a simple straight rubberized USB Type-C to Type-A cable, a combo switch and keycap puller, some extra accent keycaps for the spacebar, arrow keys, and escape key, and two extra switches. Now taking a look at the board, the AL-75 is an all-aluminum casing, RGB capable, ANSI layout, non-exploded 75% layout keyboard. It's got some decently slim bezels all around, with the left and right sides being the thinnest parts. There's no visible Yunzi branding anywhere on the board, and there's a polished shiny case badge with some line art of the planet Saturn on it. The case badge also doubles as a storage compartment for the wireless dongle, since the board is both 2.4 GHz wireless and Bluetooth capable. Then on the blocker next to the arrow keys, there's a customizable LED indicator light strip. Talking a bit about the overall quality of the case, the casing is very nicely sandblasted without any noticeable imperfections. The board has this nice and smooth metallic finish that makes the board feel really premium. The finish doesn't pick up any noticeable fingerprints, and all the edges around the board are slightly chamfered. Taking a look at the sides of the board has a simple looking box on wedge side profile and doesn't look flashy at all. Underneath the board on the bottom case, it's kept super simple without any branding, 4 small case feet, and 8 visible hex screws for opening up the board. On the back of the board towards the middle, we'll find the USB-C port sandwiched in between the toggle switches for switching between wired and wireless modes and OS selection. Then when it comes to software, the board is unfortunately not QMK or VIA compatible, but the board does have some pretty bare-bones software that lets you tweak things if you want to play with lighting settings, change up your key mappings, set up macro commands, or check the board's battery life. Now checking out the keycaps, these are a set of high-quality double-shot PBT plastic cherry profile keycaps. The legending is nice and sharp and should be plenty good enough for most people to use right out of the box no problem. Texture-wise, the keycap surface is nice and smooth, making them really comfortable to type with. Now for the switches that came with the board. My unit came with Yunzi's Cocoa Cream V2 linear switches. These are a factory-lubed 5-pin linear switch, with the switch made up of a long pole palm stem, a polycarbonate top housing, and a nylon bottom housing. Since the switches are fairly new, I couldn't really find any numbers on the spring weight or the bottom out, so all I can say for now is that the switches are really easy to actuate, feel nice and smooth, and bottom out pretty quickly. Then finally, for the general overview of the board. The stabilizers that came with the board are plate-mounted and factory-lubed pretty consistently for the most part, but they aren't perfect. In my testing so far, I didn't notice any tick or rattle on any of the 2U stabs, but the spacebar did have a noticeable ticking on the left side. But since the stabs are plate-mounted, it's a really easy fix since you won't need to take the entire board apart to work on them. And now for a quick typing test of the board in its stock form, followed up by a teardown of the board right after. Now to get the board open, as mentioned earlier, there are a total of 8 screws underneath the board keeping the top and bottom case pieces together. After disconnecting the single JSD cable for the daughter board, we can check out the bottom case. Inside the bottom case, you'll find the daughter board and 2 batteries with a total capacity of 6,000 mAh. No internal weights, covers, or anything else to add any extra weight. Then checking out the plate assembly, the assembly is gasket mounted using silicone gasket jackets that slide onto tabs on the top and bottom parts of the plate. Then taking the plate assembly apart, the board is using a flex cut polycarbonate plate, some plate foam, some IXPE foam, and a PET switch film. Then underneath the PCB, there's a stuck adhesive layer of rear PCB foam with a protective film attached that acts as case foam. Taking a look at the PCB, it's hot swappable with some unbranded hot swap sockets, south-facing LEDs without any alternative layout support, and a lot of flex cuts. But thankfully, we do have cutouts for PCB-mounted stabilizers in case you want to swap out the included plate mounts for your own aftermarket PCB mount stabs. And with that, that pretty much covers the entire board. Now, just like most of the builds I've taken a look at recently, out of curiosity, I did want to hear how the board would sound without any of the major sound modifying layers, like the IXPE foam or the PET switch film. So here's the final sound test of the board just using case and plate foam. Then afterwards, I'll be giving my final thoughts on the board as a whole. Alright, so right out of the box, the board to me sounded pretty nice. Minus the easily fixable spacebar tick, the board in its stock foamed up form, paired with factory lube Yunzi Coco Cream V2 linears sounded pretty deep. And with the PE foam and the PET switch film removed, the board sounded really clean and clacky, which is pretty surprising for a board with all the flex cuts. So I'm sure that a lot of people that plan on picking this board up would be pretty happy with the sound that the board is capable of producing. There's honestly really no need to open up the board unless you want to rip out the major sound modifying foams or if you plan on installing some aftermarket PCB mounted stabilizers. For me though, I think just swapping out the switches would already go a really long way as an upgrade path for the board. Then talking about the typing feel, the board, even with its pairing of a polycarbonate plate and a flex cut PCB, has a slightly rigid typing feel that isn't too soft. But that isn't a bad thing. The board has this good middle ground stiffness that doesn't make the board feel too flexible or too stiff at the same time. It honestly hits a pretty good sweet spot. Now, when it comes to the looks and aesthetics of the board, since looks are subjective depending on the person, me personally, I'm really liking the board's overall design. The lack of branding makes for a really clean looking board, and the polished shiny case badge with the planet line art adds a little bit of character. The overall case finish is really well done, and like I mentioned earlier, makes the board feel nice and premium. As for the layout, I like that we finally have a budget aluminum keyboard with a non-exploded 75% layout. Since I feel like a lot of the time, if you look around for budget aluminum 75% keyboards nowadays, a lot of the time you'll find it using an exploded layout with a volume knob, which I know isn't everyone's favorite. It's just nice seeing a different offering in the market. Now to close things off, my one nitpick is just a lack of QMK and VIA support. Other than that, I think the board looks really clean and minimal, sounds great right out of the box, and all of the inclusions from the nicely finished case, high quality, good sounding and smooth feeling factory lube switches, and high quality double shot keycaps make this board worth its $110 price tag. So with that being said, that's it for this video. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a comment and drop a like, as these videos take a lot of work. And if you want to see more content just like this, please consider subscribing. It would really mean a lot. Thanks again to Yunzi for sending this board out for review, and all relevant links and where to get your hands on this board will be listed down below. Thank you guys for watching. Till next time, Merkeebs out.